Hi everyone, thank you for joining the BIM 360 webinar. This is Zach Krummel, I'm the subject matter expert for Autodesk Point Layout for Autodesk. And today our topic we'll be going over is creating layout and verification points in Navisworks Manage using Autodesk Point Layout. First, I'm just going to go over a quick agenda and go over some ground rules. This webinar will be exactly a half an hour long and will end at 4:30 p.m. You are all muted during the conference, but you can ask questions as well at the end. So if you do have questions, you can enter those questions in this GoToWebinar dialog box, and we can answer those at the end. We will have 10 minutes towards the end of this to go over any questions that you guys do ask. So we're going to begin the topic discussion, spend about 5 minutes going over some slides, and then we'll spend a majority of our time in a live training using Autodesk Point Layout within Navisworks. So really, just kind of the first slide to get us going is Autodesk Point Layout is primarily a layout QA/QC and as-building tool. It is an add-in to Autodesk Revit, AutoCAD, and Navisworks. So just kind of a first slide to kind of get us introduced here, getting BIM data into the field. So currently there are quite a few existing inefficiencies in layout. It is time consuming, it's very labor intensive, and there's many times rework involved. Control is not carried throughout the project is probably one of the biggest ones. So not only creating site control, but also establishing building control throughout the life of the job. So after pours, creating new control, that is definitely a big one. Stakeholders also not having confidence in trade layouts. So through this process, we can actually create points in the coordinated Navis model in AutoCAD or Revit. So we know what we're building off of has been signed off, it has been coordinated, and we're building off exactly what should have been installed. Kind of the last part here is also most of the time field conditions, we're not able to get back into the model, so we're not able to actually have a true as-built model deliverable. So those are just some points there that we wanted to go over on inefficiencies. So when we look at Autodesk Point Layout, what is it? It's actually an add-in. But what we're doing is creating points within the BIM or CAD model and exporting and importing that coordinate information to the field. This is for primarily construction layout, QA/QC, and as-building. It makes the office time a lot faster and more accurate, but also the field side of things is a lot faster and more accurate. So we are utilizing robotic total stations or total stations for this. We will get into that here in a little bit. Benefits. The control is continued through the entire project. Not only do the guys in the office understand the control and where those are, they can also create additional control. The coordinated model-driven layout, I think, is a little bit more highlighted on the Navis side than it is on Revit, especially when you're looking at your Navis model. It tends to be the most coordinated, up-to-date piece of information you have. So I do see a lot of GCs and MEP firms using the Navis model more than ever. Improved QA/QC in the field. You're able to verify anything out in the field versus where it was in the model. Owner as-built models is another huge benefit. So we look at the field layout workflow. Within Revit, Navis, or AutoCAD, we're creating and managing the model. Really nothing's changed there. The same workflow that you guys are using today. The next step is creating and managing those points using Point Layout. And once again, this is in Revit, Navis, and CAD. The next step is actually transferring that information to the field, to a robotic total station. Point Layout does work with all types of field hardware. The export file types that we do create are compatible with Leica, Topcon, and Trimble total stations. So we're actually going to go physically lay those points out or collect those points in the field. A robotic total station is measuring angle and distance. It's using control points to be set up, and you can go verify or lay out anything that you have in the model. The last step is as-built models and QA/QC. This is a screenshot of some slab analysis in Revit. There's quite a few different ways that we can bring that information back in, understand how far it was off in tolerance, update models, and also do some analysis. Just a real quick overview here on Point Layout. It sits in all three desktop applications, as well as having quite a few different times that we can integrate with BIM 360 Field. So we can assign points to tasks, and we can also assign deviation to points where we're doing some QA/QC and trying to make sure what was installed out in the field matches our model. We can create issues for those with BIM 360 Field. So all three platforms pretty much doing the same thing. I'm just going to kind of briefly go over this slide, and then we'll get into the actual use of the software. So pretty much the benefits are improving everything that we went over in the previous screens here. I think the biggest one is reducing the time and cost of construction and the rework. You're installing on the most updated model. You know it's in the right spot, and you're not having to go in and do any rework. So we're going to get into the live training now, and we're going to spend about 15 minutes going over Point Layout within Navisworks. So within Navisworks, you can actually use Navisworks Manage back all the way till 2012. I'm just going to be using it here in 2014. This also does work in all of your 2015 products as well. I'm going to open up my Add-ins tab, and you're going to see an Autodesk Point Layout tab. We're going to go over quite a few different steps here to get you set up. The first thing we go over, especially in CAD and Revit, is coordinate systems and control. You can't create control points in Navisworks, but you can import control points from many different locations. Whether you got those from your site surveyor or your survey team, you can bring those control points in, or you can bring control points in that you created from AutoCAD or Revit or even Civil 3D. So kind of the first tool I'm going to go over here is the import points tool, and actually bring in our control file. Most of the times we're talking about a text or a CSV file. Those are also the same file types that we can export as well. I'm going to bring in, you know, several control points. I'm going to use my point role as control point, and I can just hit OK. So it's telling me 7 points are imported. One thing I do like to do is actually change the size, color, and scale of the points. There's actually one control point down here. It's really small. First thing I like to do is go to Set Scale and Set Color. I like to use this filter. And you can choose, you know, any group of points by numbers, descriptions, etc. Select those points. And then you can actually physically change the size of that point. So I'm just going to make it a 10 out of 10. You can see here I have, you know, several control points. These would have been site control that we would have used to orient and set up our total station. One thing you do want to do prior to control is using the coordinate system tools that we have in Point Layout in both CAD and Revit to make sure your model is matching your job site coordinates. That's going to be done initially for setup. You can also change colors of points as well, any type of point, not just control. And maybe I want to make these, you know, 7 points or so, just a green. So, you know, you can actually change the color on here as well. I'm actually going to change that to shaded mode. And now we have our green control points. So that's really a quick overview on in importing control. But as long as you've taken care of your coordinate systems in the field as well as in the office, both of those will be matching. So one of the largest, the most important tools that we're going to go over is adding points to the Navis model. One of the benefits to doing this in Navisworks is all of the file types that you can bring in. You might have some IFC structural models from, you know, some structural detailing programs that you might want to mark for embeds, anchor bolts, things like that. Also, any other types of, you know, third-party models you can mark as well. So one of the slower portions is just actually a manual point placement. I'm not going to spend a lot of time on this, but you can enter your point number, a description. You can type in any type of description you want to. System, I'm just going to say this is a wall, and scale is the actual physical size of that point. There is a point role. This helps you filter and manage your points later on, similar to a layer in AutoCAD. You can add to this list. I'm just going to call these points that I want to go stake out. So the point program in here works kind of just like how you've used it before. If you have an X, it's going to create a point at intersections. You can also place points wherever you want to manually. So it's more of a manual process. Granted, it's not used a ton, but you can just place points wherever you need them. If you do want to go into more of a top view and go into an orthographic, you can snap to center lines and do wireframe. There's a bunch of different ways you can actually use that. One of the tools I do want to highlight on the Navi side is the automated point placement. It's called Mark Selections, where you can select a series of objects, sleeves, stub-ups. We'll go over quite a few different scenarios here, where you can just hit a couple buttons and tell the software where you want to mark. So you can do this by pour schedule, a bunch of different ways. You can also select selection sets. So if you have a selection set that you've created, you can actually just mark that entire selection set at once. So I'm going to hit this Mark Selections tool down here in kind of the bottom left. And it's going to ask us a couple questions. I'm going to mark geometry. Top center or bottom center really wouldn't come into play here. And then you also can mark the bottoms, the tops, or both the top and the bottom. Rods is actually for your trapeze and your clevis hangers. We'll spend some time on that. I'm just going to mark all and mark both my tops and bottoms. Once again, you can use the actual item name, a standard description, or custom. I'm just going to use a custom description and call these wall points, for example. You can also get as descriptive as you want here, and I'm going to hit OK. What point system? I'm just going to call it wall. Hit OK. It's going to spend a little bit of time. You can now see there's a bunch of little points on here that are tops and bottoms. I'm also going to change the scale here real quick just so we can see these a little bit easier. And make these a 7 out of 10. So now you can actually see those points that we've created. Once again, this can be a Revit model, CAD, IFCs, a bunch of different file types. If you're doing coordination and things are moving around, you can actually move these points with them. A bunch of different options, but that is really a quick method and one of the most used methods on the Navi side for creating points. Really nothing to it. For other objects like stub-ups, maybe you have some mechanical stub-ups you want to mark. Same thing, mark selections. We're just going to mark the top centers in this case. I'm just going to use a standard description and hit OK. Once again, going in, marking all the top centers of those marks. Hangers is also one that quite a few people have asked about. We can mark those. Same thing with embeds, anchor bolts. You know, select those, mark selections. We're going to go to geometry in this case and mark the rods. Going in, might be a little hard to see right now. I'm going to hide the floor. Got some analytical floors in here as well. Now you can see on top of these trapeze hangers, we're marking both ends of the rods. So you can actually mark 7,000 hangers in a matter of seconds here. So a little bit different than the Revit side or AutoCAD. One thing I do kind of prefer in this environment is you're constantly doing coordination, clash detection, things are moving around. You can quickly add points to these objects whenever you need to once they're coordinated. Also, you can bring these points from Navisworks back into Revit or CAD if you wanted that to be the environment where your points stay. So all three platforms can speak back and forth to each other. You're not stuck in just Navisworks or Revit. You can still go back to CAD or wherever you guys want to manage these points. In terms of exporting, really nothing to it. We're just going to export points. A few pieces of information here, XYZ, what order you want, coordinate system. You really don't have to do anything to the coordinate system in Navisworks. It already understands which coordinate system it was created in. Filter I do use a lot. You can choose which type of filter you want. Maybe you just wanted to export some wall points or however you created them. You can export just that point group. So you really have the ability to get exactly what you want and export just those points. You're not forced to export 30,000 points. If you just want your first floor, you could export those. It also gives you elevation filters. There's the roll we talked about earlier. So a bunch of different ways you can filter it out and go send these points out to the field. So I'm actually going to do nothing to my coordinate system. I'm going to do nothing to the filter. That's going to export everything. And I'm just going to call this my Autodesk test design points and export these to my just to my downloads folder here real quick. There are two bits of piece of BIM 360 field integration down here at the bottom. You can attach this CSV file to a BIM 360 field attachment. So this is actually attaching this to a task. So you can assign to one of your field layout men, here's a file of control and points. He can download that from field on his tablet and actually access those directly and use those for his total station. So I'm actually going to spend more time on the issue side, but we do have the ability to attach these as well. I'm just going to hit OK. And I exported 139 points. So it's really that fast. Doesn't take a lot of time at all. And here's my Autodesk test design point. So it's actually just a CSV file, point number, XYZ, description. This is the actual one of the files that he is actually placing on his data collector and running the total station out in the field. So just we're going to do a real quick QAQC. We do have about 5 more minutes on this portion of it. Just going to change a couple of these values, save this off, and pretend like we got this information back from the field. This is our as-built information. So it's actually, I'm just going to call it as-built here and save that off. All right. So first step in the workflow is I'm going to use this compare points tool. This is actually comparing what happened out in the field versus what was in our model. So I didn't change all of these, but we'll kind of go over this workflow here. So a couple of these points I changed. I'm going to look at this wall points one here. And what it's doing is it's zooming on that point and centering it in the screen. It's this point here. And it's telling me out in the field this point changed 0.75 decimal feet. So if you do want to use a tolerance, you can set a tolerance down here. You know, if you want to do 0.125 for an eighth of an inch or however you want to, whatever tolerance you want to do, you can filter those out. You can also filter these out by description. So if you just wanted wall points, you can just see those points there. Really allows you to see exactly what happened and filter out your results so you can choose the points that were worse than the tolerance that you set. This report, once you kind of see, you know, filter this out and understand which points you want to create issues for, you can hit this BIM 360 field button up at the top. So it is going to ask for your username and password. It's also going to ask you for your project. I'm just going to use a fire station, for example. And then this entire report is actually being added to this QAQC issue editor. So you can choose an issue ID, that entire piece of information in the previous screens under description. This is just reading what you had in your field database. So you can say who needs to fix it, when they need to fix it by, status, due date, priorities high. This is concrete division 3. So you can actually build this library out, export this to BIM 360 field, and these will come up as issues. So this is really you know, something that the MEP coordinator could do with some sleeve points or you know, some penetrations that they want to bring back in. But that's really kind of it on the QAQC side. You also can export this to Excel as well. That is actually, we're kind of running out of time here. We do have about 10 minutes for question and answer, and we can go over any questions and any parts that anybody does have. So if you do have questions, you can start asking those now, and I can start seeing those. One of the questions I've got so far here is, why would I want to use this Navisworks over Revit? I think that's a great question. The part of this that I really prefer in Navisworks is I think From someone that hasn't used Point Layout, this is an easier environment. It's a little less scary with the tools. You don't have to be a Revit expert. You really just need to know the Point Layout tools in here and add those as you go. The other part of it is the Navis model I tend to see is a lot more updated, it's coordinated, and tends to be the most accurate piece of information we have. So I do see a lot of people that prefer to add the points in this environment because they know this is a lot more updated than Revit in that case. There is a little bit more training involved on the Revit side. There's, you have to be a little bit more comfortable in Revit than you do need to be in Navisworks for this as well. Are there any other questions? We still have plenty of time to go over some questions here. Another question we have is, how does this integrate with BIM 360 Field? I went over the first part there. You can attach these to tasks. So if you do have some control points and foundation points you want to export, you can create a task called first floor pour 1 points. He knows those are just for that portion of the project, and assign that to a user. He gets his notification and can download that CSV file. Really, a lot of these tools, we're really just focusing on the workflows. So this is integrated with a lot of your current QAQC issues and tasks. So we're really, the verification and layout points, we're really just trying to get this integrated with a lot of your current workflows that you guys are using. And just if there's any more questions, we still have time to answer a few more or go over any other points that you guys do want to look at. Let's give it a couple more minutes here. All right. Well, I don't see any more questions. We're going to end a little bit early here. If anyone does have questions, they can respond. Oh, we actually got one more here. There is a question saying you can't currently see the point number to each point. Is there a button to turn on and off the points? There are. So there is a show hide points button up here as well. If at any time you click on a point, all of that information is over here in attributes. So one place that I really prefer to do that is this manage points tool. So point 5004 and point 5002 for maybe, for example, I didn't want those points. You still can just hide them like you typically do in Navisworks. You can also use the Show Hide Points button. So you can use this filter, and you can say either I want to hide or show certain points. So I'm going to use this filter and maybe choose 5002, 5001, hit Apply. And now these points are going to be part of my hidden tool. So now those points will be hidden. Then you can also use the Manage Points tool. This actually does quite a few different things where you can say, I want to zoom to point 1000, so it's going to zoom to it. This actually was a previous point, so I'm actually going to use a different one. Let's try point 1002 there. I'm going to zoom to that point. You can also change the color, select it, delete it, show it, or hide it. So if you also wanted to just change the color as well, you can do that there. You really have the ability to kind of show or hide anything at any point. And we don't have any other questions that I see on this list here. Well, I appreciate it. Thank you very much. And thanks for attending.